In this video, we're going to talk about how to give constructive feedback. Primary observation is far better when you're giving feedback than secondary reports of what other people have seen. So, the first and most important aspect of all good constructive feedback is that you should make it observed, and ideally observed by you. Second, you need to make it balanced. That is, drawing a fair balance between positive feedback that reinforces good behaviours and good results, and negative feedback, feedback which identifies problems that the other person needs to resolve. Next, it's important to make all feedback specific. General comments are very hard to respond to. It's very hard to know what to do with a comment like, "Yeah, your work wasn't quite good enough." However, if you can be very specific about the area which needs improvement and the kind of failings that you've identified, then you will get much better results. Next, it's important that all feedback is timely. That is to say, give the feedback as soon after the observation as possible. However, never make that your priority over protecting the person you're giving feedback to. Don't give feedback in public in front of other people. And finally, I would say that it's important that feedback is action-oriented. You frame your feedback in such a way that the person you're giving feedback to can act on that feedback and start to make a difference in their behaviours and therefore in their performance. A great way to give constructive feedback is the Situation Behaviour Impact Model, or SBI model. Start off by describing the situation or the context in which you observed the performance, and then describe the behaviour that you observed, and finally the impact of that behaviour on the outcomes or the performance. It's also important to think about the context in which you are delivering your feedback. First, and perhaps most important, do it in a safe place, where both you and, critically, the person you're giving the feedback to feels safe and comfortable and can relax. Second, always take responsibility for the feedback you're giving. Use statements like, "I observe," because when you express the feedback from your own point of view, you are avoiding being accusatory. The alternative, of course, is "you do this," which will feel to the other person as though you're accusing them of something and create a defensive response in them, a need to defend themselves, and therefore they won't be listening to the feedback that you're giving. As much as you can, be empathetic, understand the other person's point of view, and therefore adjust your approach to the emotions that they're feeling and showing. The next thing I'd say is always celebrate progress. Recognize and reward achievement, progress, improvements. And at the point where performance has reached a good level, dial back the amount of critical feedback you give and focus largely on positive reinforcing feedback. Next, I would say encourage a dialogue with the other person. Encourage them to respond to what they're hearing, to give their point of view. But do it in a way that it is a constructive conversation rather than a defence of what they've been doing. See what their perception is of their performance and the behaviours that have led to it. Throughout the whole feedback process, avoid judging the other person and stay objective. Focus on the behaviours that you've observed and the outcomes that you've seen, and avoid trying to infer what that person can and can't do or what their motivations might have been. You can't possibly know that, although through the dialogue, you may learn that because they may choose to tell you. And finally, avoid overloading the person you're giving feedback to, because if there is a lot, then they simply won't absorb any more. And if you keep adding more and more, they'll start to forget the stuff at the beginning. So focus your feedback on the things that matter most, the one, two, or at most three important things that they need to hear. That way, you can improve their performance incrementally focusing on the biggest things first so that you get the biggest bang for your buck when you give feedback. After feedback, always follow up. During the feedback session, find out what support they need, make your offer of that support, and then after the feedback, give that support. Continually monitor and check in on their progress. Feedback is one of the most important ways that we as individuals progress and grow and develop in our lives and in our professional careers. And if you are any kind of manager, supervisor, or leader, then it is your responsibility to give good, constructive feedback to the people for whom you are responsible. Please do give this video a like if you enjoyed it or learned from it. I'll be making loads more great management courses videos for you, so please do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you don't miss any of it. I look forward to seeing you in the next video, and in the meantime, keep learning.